Breaking news coming in this morning where India has broken all previous records of the highest single day rise in cases. The past 24 hours have given us over 1 lakh cases. 1,15,736 to be precise, all coming in a span of just 1 day. This is the highest ever we have recorded since the beginning of the pandemic. Sukirti Trivedi with us for the very latest. Sukirti, bad news this is. All right, as we look into those pictures, in fact, those numbers coming in right now, India's highest ever daily case is being recorded now. The past 24 hours have thrown over 1,15,000 cases. And it's not just the cases, mind you, it's also the number of deaths. 360 lives lost in just a span of 24 hours. That's a record, really. And like I said, since the beginning of the pandemic, we have not had such high numbers being reported in one single day. Sukirti Trivedi, I'm told, is now with us. Sukirti, this is really bad news for the country.
Well, yes. In fact, you know, even in terms of the expectations, there were expectations. There was a certain buzz that the cases would be around 1.07 lakh. There were certain reports about that, but it is even higher than that. It's 1,15,000, India's highest record till date, and proves what has been said earlier as well, that India's second wave is proving to be worse than the first one. And that is something Dr. V.K. Paul, who is a Niti Aayog member and also the head of India's vaccine committee, said yesterday, that the steep rise in cases, the pace at which cases are rising, all of that is higher than the first wave. And that is something the center has also repeatedly told the states. And also the number of deaths that we've seen in the last 24 hours, 630 deaths. If you look at just the number of deaths that have happened in the last 7 days, we were around 354 deaths on 31st March. And today the number stands at almost double of that. We saw a little higher deaths on 3rd of April, which was 714. But just in the last 7 days, the deaths have gone from about 350 to around 600 or 700, and that is a very big concern for the government at this point of time, controlling the fatality rate. That is something that all their central teams that have been sent to at least 50 districts across Maharashtra, Chhattisgarh and Punjab, that is what these teams are going to be focusing on, and also the health infrastructure to ensure that the severity of the disease, the patients that are in ICUs, that are on ventilators, they are being taken care of.
Right. So just to put this in perspective for our viewers, as of 7th of April today, more than a year after the pandemic, we are sitting at the highest number we have seen spike up in a single day. The trajectory of that growth, that spike in the graph that you see on your screen right now, is the highest. The sudden spike that you see going up over there, that's the highest. That means we've recorded so many numbers, over 1 lakh numbers in the minimum time, really. And then number of deaths also rising. All this is coming at a time when, Sukirti, you've been pointing out, and our reporters across the country also pointing out, that the medical infrastructure is extremely overburdened. Maharashtra, for example, is run out of oxygen. They've run out of blood. They've run out of oxygen beds, ICUs. And more, one of the most emerging trends of the second wave, a second wave which none of the government officials are recognizing as this double mutation being the right cause behind it, but also for the first time acknowledging that the younger population is getting impacted the most, and it's not just young adults, it's children as well from 15 years of age who are now contributing to these numbers, Sukirti.
Well, yes, absolutely. That is something Dr. Harshvardhan, the Union Health Minister, pointed out in a meeting with the health ministers of 11 states yesterday, that we are not only seeing an extreme surge in cases, but also the fact that most of these new cases are coming up in the 15 to 44 age group. And that is the first admission ever coming from the government side, that it is the younger population that is also being affected. And my colleague Parimal Kumar has also just sent in data of, you know, the top five states that have been recording the highest numbers. And if you look at the last 1 month for them, there are states like Maharashtra where even children below the age of 5 years, over 9,000 such children have been infected with COVID. Over 14,000 children who are in the 6 to 10 age group, these are not even teenagers, just 6 to 10 year olds, at least 14,000 of them have been infected in the last 1 month. And there's data of Chhattisgarh, Delhi, Karnataka, as well as other states that goes to prove the same, that these are all below 17 age group, all these children that have been infected in thousands in the last 1 month. So there are multiple challenges for the government at this point of time. One, of course, is the sharply increasing daily deaths in India, and then again this younger population age group. Also, something we want to point out about the state specific scenario. One, of course, is Maharashtra, the biggest concern always. At least 55,000 of the cases in the last 24 hours have been reported from Maharashtra. If you look at a state like Chhattisgarh, this is what the health secretary was pointing out yesterday. It is a very small state if you compare it in terms of population, if you compare it in terms of area. But in the last 24 hours, they've recorded nearly 10,000 cases, 9,921 cases to be specific. That's 10,000 cases at least coming from a state like Chhattisgarh.
Right.
While much bigger states like Karnataka or UP have much lesser numbers than Chattisgarh.
But important to point out here, Sukirti, there are also states which are testing much less.
Right now, looking
for example, UP is testing much less, and that's the reason why we see lesser numbers coming from there as well. So these numbers that we get from states have to be looked in that perspective as well. But for all our viewers joining in right now, India is waking up to its highest ever single day rise since the beginning of the pandemic. In the past 24 hours, we've reported over 1,15,000 cases, and this is bad news for the country.